everyone. Today I'm here to quickly share with you some of my reading statistics from 2014. At the end of 2014 and into the beginning of 2015, I used a reading spreadsheet that I stole from the Book Riot website, which I will leave linked down below if you're interested, to compile these statistics. Personally, I think it's a fun and fascinating way to analyze my reading habits, and judging by the amount of videos I've seen like this one, I assume that you feel the same way. Or at least I hope so. So, let's get started. First, general statistics. In 2014, I read 69 books with a total of 20,778 pages, which means that the average book length was 301 pages. I read an average of 5.7 books a month, with May and November being my best months in which I read 9 books. I did full video reviews for 55% of the books I read in 2014. This number was much lower than I expected, but I'm still satisfied with it overall. It is a vast improvement. The average star rating of the books I read in 2014, according to Goodreads, is 4.7, which means I either read a lot of good books in 2014 or was way too generous. At the beginning of 2014, I owned 79 unread physical books, and somewhere in the middle of the year, I owned over 100 unread physical books, and I now currently own 70 unread physical books. Overall, not a great shift from the beginning number to the end number, but my buying and owning habits have definitely changed for the better in 2014. Now on to gender, race, and nationality. Nearly 54% of the books that I read were written by female authors, about 36% by male authors, 10% were written by a male-female team, and to my knowledge, 0% were written by non-binary authors, or authors that do not fit into the accepted male-female gender identities. In 2014, I read 11 books by authors of color, which is about 16%. Much better than years past, but definitely in need of improvement. Speaking of areas that are in need of improvement, 68% of the books I read in 2014 were written by authors from the United States, about 13% were from Canada, 12% from the UK, about 3% from Australia, and the remaining 4% were by authors from Japan, Spain, and Taiwan. Also, I only read 3 translated works in 2014. Now onto format and source. 81% of the books I read were physical, 16% were ebooks, and about 3% were audiobooks. Of the 56 physical books I read, 31 were paperbacks and 25 were hardbacks. About 48% of the books I read came from my personal library, i.e. books that I owned physically. About 29% came from the local library. About 14% of the books I owned / read on my Kindle or phone. And approximately 9% came from other library sources such as interlibrary loan and overdrive. Lastly, I did a very broad genre breakdown. I found it pretty difficult to categorize several of the books I read into specific genres. So the categories that I decided on are children's, YA, general fiction, which will basically include any fiction that does not fall into the previous categories, nonfiction, which will include memoirs, essay collections, etc., and sequential art, which will include graphic novels and memoirs. So here are the numbers. Children's at 3%, YA at 33%, general fiction at 28%, nonfiction at 11%, and graphic novels at 25%. And thus concludes my 2014 reading statistics. Not too many surprises, but crunching these numbers definitely solidified some areas that I need to work on in the future. This was a lot of nerdy fun for me. I hope that you enjoyed. As always, please feel free to share your thoughts on anything that I shared here today in the comments below. Thank you so much for watching, and I hope to see you soon with a brand new video.